Good morning. So, as we left off on the last video, having a few problems getting the new version of Snippet Pixie to work with the AT-SPI D-Bus interface. It was coming back and saying it's not recognized, which means that we won't be able to do things like, when we trigger a snippet to expand, we won't be able to actually send the message to say, go put this in the control that you currently have, this new paragraph. So I need to find out why it's not doing what it's supposed to do. So let's do a quick test to make sure. Let's have a quick review of what I did. And then we'll see if we can find out, spot a problem. If not, we will have to do some poking around. Okay. So why is that coming back like that? Interesting. Might just be a analysis thing there, I think, because it was working fine before. Okay, so when we create a new ex auto expander, we're just gonna be monitoring first a case. When we lose controllers, lose the window, we want to stop expanding. When we get control, we want to start expanding. And then we've got this accessible connection to the D-Bus interface. In theory, because this is potentially where the issue is, that allows us to actually send the messages. So we've got this accessible con. And then later on, when we have the got controller, we're monitoring keystrokes and the get focus. So if we get a text changed insert, that means someone's actually inserted a bit of text into something that can take it. There are other ways that a text change insert can get triggered, but we need to protect against that, which is what we're trying to do. So we get to this point here. Again, that call is saying it's not found. I don't know what's going on there. But we know that works, so. I might have to do a little tidy in a minute just to see what's what. Okay, so we come in, we start monitoring for these two types of messages, so focus and text changed. Get call. Create an event buffer. And then we start eavesdropping on that. Okay. And then that means hopefully when the get down here, the event buffer is filling up with stuff and we get events. Meanwhile, this may be part of the issue. On another connection, we try and grab. Editable text. Now, this is just for testing. It's not really what I want to do. What I really want to do is the accessible to try and get this list of interfaces it has, which it hopefully will include editable text. Okay, let's do what I want to do. And just make sure we're not doing the wrong, we're not doing anything daft. For example, that should probably be lowercase, but we'll see. So we come in here, we're making sure that we have an event happening, which is in one of these. So it begins with that. So it's either a focus or object one. So do that here. And if we get past that, we're just doing a bit of debug. And then we try and get to this point here. So we've got an accessible object. We're checking the body to see whether the third item is an insert. And we're checking they add the value at, because this is my little debug stuff to make sure that I don't do anything daft at the moment. This will go away, all of this. So we now have an accessible, we're going to call on it. Now we don't want to do that anymore. We really want to do that. Just want to do the right thing and see if it works. Coming out of this at the moment. I'll do right up here as well. So that's all gone for the moment. Let's do an error check. Yeah, I need to do a mod tidy, I think. I'll do a continue there, and I'll just use debugger at some point to check that. Maybe I'll just chuck something in here, just for the moment, to see what kind of errors I get. Failed to get controls accessible interface. In theory, we're not doing anything with it. We're just checking to see whether we get any errors. And I think we are going to, because what was happening yesterday was it was saying that this doesn't even exist. We can't even get to that interface in the D-Bus. Which is annoying. All right, let's give that a go. Okay. Might take it out. Hopefully that's picked up on there. No, don't know what's going on with that. Right, start this off. Open up an accessible app. Resize it down a bit. We've already got errors. The name, org, alley, AT-SPI accessible was not provided by any service. Ay, ay, ay. Right, okay. What are we going to do? These interfaces have, well, sorry, these services have to work, have to exist, because the run-in Snippet Pixie is already using them. So if I do SP and then I do a backtick, it expands. And that's all using the D-Bus, the existing D-Bus stuff. If I just think, if I actually stop Snippet Pixie. So that's the current one. Just make sure it doesn't do anything, right? And then in here, I'll start up the local one again. Now that's interesting. Nothing. Why on earth would that be the case? So they run in Snippet Pixie. Actually brought in. All the accessible stuff. No, it doesn't make sense. Let's close that. Check again. start again. Make sure it's not too big so I can see all the messages, okay? Okay, there is something weird going on there. Why on earth would that be the case? And off it goes again. That is very, very strange. Very strange. Okay, so that's working now. If I stop Snippet Pixie up here, while that's still running down below, and then carry on, Ken is not responding. That must mean there's a service being brought up by the fact that Snippet Pixie depends on it. And I'm not doing that with a new version. Let's see, let's go. Well, that looks as though it's up and in. So if I bring up Snippet Pixie again, starts working straight away. If I go to the D-Bus stuff and do another check, nothing's changed. Okay. I know what it is. Well, I have an idea what it is. And there's a pain unless there's another way around it. So if I go look at the current file code, I have to initialize the AT-SPI interface as such, right at the beginning of there, look. AT-SPI in it. Now that's a kind of a GTK thing though. Well, not GTK. I mean, it's part of the Vala setup stuff, using the AT-SPI wrappers for the C code as such. So, there is, right, so I go through, register all my listeners, blah, blah, blah. I do have an exit if things go wrong. And then later on, got to do lots of checks there, don't I? Deregister listeners. Quit there. So if we fail there, we exit. If we fail there, we exit. And then if the app is running and we're doing a cleanup at the end or close down, we exit. Okay. Right. So that means somehow, somewhere in my Go code, I need to tell AT-SPI to bring up and I have no idea on how or where to do that. So, at the beginning, we have to go get the address. So we connect to the normal session bus. So every Linux desktop as such has a D-Bus session bus. So it's private to your session. But the accessibility stuff is brought up on its own bus. I wonder if that'll even fail. Well, no, it didn't fail. Let's do a quick test there. Let's do Ali bus address. Let's do that. And okay, let's take close that off. Make sure Snippet Pixie is down. Make this and run it. See, that gets the address. It's just it doesn't initialize it. So it exists, or there's knowledge of where the bus address is. Don't know whether that means it's up or down. Don't know. I mean, I've connected to it. It didn't bail. In theory, I'm monitoring, but nothing's coming through it. Dock time. Okay, let's go. When a normal application starts up, people will want to find the accessibility bus. Then got to blah 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 blah. Okay, what it says here? That get address should start the bus, should launch it. Okay. So there's an org alley status. Didn't mean to click on that. Meant to click on that. Okay. Well, the XML doesn't have what I hoped. Let's do a little experiment. Actually, let's do a little experiment in code first, and then I'll just start using tools. There are some D-Bus tools, though, so I could actually start poking around and see what comes back, and then see how that works. So here, I think it's worth saying, okay, we've got an address. But is it up and running? I wonder. What if it goes? What if it goes down as soon as it realizes nothing's listening and there's like a scope problem here? We'll find out. Let's see. See if that status thing works. So, what we need to do here basically this. So what we're going to do. Reuse that. Look at status. Now that, it didn't tell me how to use it. I'll start looking at code here because okay, just is enabled in theory. Right, status is enabled. Store that into the alley status. Now to get alley bus status, alley bus status. That's just going to report it. It's not going to do anything as a result. But in theory, theory, we will now see that it's not up because I stopped it. But I reckon it will say it is actually up. Ah. That's so strange. So that means that's lying at the moment. Maybe that's a user thing, is it? Status. Just says it's running. So there's something that Snippet Pixie, should we call it Classic now? Snippet Pixie Classic. Something about the way that it does that init through the Vala libraries. is poking that bus to be up and running and keeping it there until it says go exit. So I think somehow the new version is to say, hey, I'm going to start listening on this. Can you make sure you're up and running? But I don't know how. Let's look for init. Okay. So there, I was looking for that. So when toolkit accessibility, changes. Okay. I'm just wondering whether I should poke it, but if oh, that's the one there, isn't it? Is that the one? G settings, key changed. So we're doing that. That's calling out. What's interesting, though, is that in theory, it should already be up and running. So that should have been used. Bring it up. So that should already be there, but it's not. I'm confused because I mean, in theory, that bus should be available for me to use and go, are you enabled? Although, get that. We are getting introspection data. Where's that been used? Oh, okay. All right. So it's on the alley bus path. That's interesting. So I should be able to call org alley status is enabled. On that path. Let's find out. So, all Cali status is the object. But it's on the bus path. It's the interface on that path. And I should be able to still call that. In theory? Let's find out. The name org alley status was not provided by any service files. Okay, let's try this then. It can't be right. Right, yeah, the object does not exist at path org alley bus. This is interesting. So org alley status. is there? I wonder. It's the Go D-Bus package. Get the object, get property. Okay, let's see. Is enabled. What's going on? Why is it not doing all this stuff it should be doing? Golan's having a bad day, I think. So I should be able to do get property p string. I wonder if I do no, it's not going to work. Okay, I'll try this. So we do get property. space between each of those. Actually, I should probably use the formatting one, but anyway, come back to that another day. Okay, so in theory, get that property. I might need to change that connection object to status. Yeah, running out of time soon as well. Okay. Progress. Let's try something sick. We'll change that to status and see what happens. Because that's the interface. Failed to get any bus status. The name or galley status was not provided, so it's fast. Okay. So, false there. Not going to go any further, really, is it? Can I set a property? I can. That seems a little bit dubious as to whether it'll work, but should we try? Let's do that. So we will response possibly an error. Okay, how to set. Then let's go get it. No such interface. It's not going to work, and I'm just mucking about with different interfaces on the same path. Can't really do that. It's not provided. In theory, I can take all these out. Okay, I've got to finish up. I've got to stand up in a couple of minutes. So, still a mystery as to how I get things up and running. How do I get? I mean, there's. I don't think Go D-Bus will have anything to like. Start or init. Interesting. Not sure that's what I need to do, but think the issue I have finding a way to initialize or to tell. I've got to tell the AT-SPI that I'm listening. And that it's worth sending signals. That's what the init does in the Vala code that I used to have, I think. I'll have to look into that. So there's got to be something somewhere. That does that. The only other way I can think of doing it is actually calling the launcher and saying go enable. There's something like LA1. But in theory, it's called without any params. Anyway, I've got to go. So thanks for watching. Until next time, you take care. Bye.